Now back to the State Line Sports Hour on Rockford's top source for high school sports. News Talk 1440 WROK.
Hey, Dave Schmidt and Matt Nestor on the State Line Sports Hour with our producer, Tom Warner. Beautiful day outside today, and waiting for Coach Shane Bouch to give us a call back. So, you know what? They had a late game last night.
That they did.
And he lives up in Beloit. He has to make the trip down from Wisconsin all the time. But they've had a great year. And this is their last year, of course, in the Northeastern Athletic Conference.
Yep.
Making some changes. Next year, I think Ottawa Marquette will be in for football only. And then Harvest Christian out of Elgin will take over the spot for Rockford Christian. But Rockford Christian next year gets to join that Big Northern. You know, last year when they were making their drive to go down the state, I kept hearing from people saying, oh, they can't handle Big Northern schools. Nah, that's not anymore. They can't say that.
I was going to say, I think they're in pretty good hands right now.
And, you know, he lost a bunch of kids from last year. He lost a big guy in, who's a walk-on at Illinois now. Drew Anderson went down there, and they lost Arthur Ford to play basketball. So it's kind of one of those deals where you got to, you know.
Yeah. But they're moving right along.
Yeah.
It hasn't fazed them at all. He's got some younger players in there, and they're doing well.
And the thing I like about what he's doing is he took off a couple of years because of some family issues. He was at Beloit Memorial where they went to state 2 years in a row, which is very, very good.
Yeah.
I mean, anywhere, but he did it everywhere he went. He turned a losing program into a winning program, and so it's kind of good. All right. Right now, we're glad to have with us Rockford Christian Boys High School basketball coach Shane Bouch. And first of all, congratulations last night on your big win over Christian Life, 58-39.
Thanks a lot. Really appreciate it. Great win for our guys. You know, it's always a rivalry game, you know, between private schools and very well attended, big crowd, spirited crowd. So it's a game that I think both schools look forward to. Certainly, I know our kids do, and they're very excited about last night, and they performed really well, so I was proud of them.
How good is it, you know, early in the season to get a rivalry game like that? You know, you kind of get out of those early season tournaments to get a big turnaround like that to get your kids motivated early in the year.
Yeah, it's a great point. You know, I mean, the games thus far this season have either been road games for us with, you know, hardly anybody there, or a tournament game where, you know, the environment isn't anything to speak of either. So those games are kind of almost remind you of summer league games in a way where there's only nobody there. You know, we're over at the Oregon tournament. They don't even announce the starters. You know, so it feels like, you know, you play two games in a day on that Saturday. It really does have a summer type of feel. So this is our first home game, and you know, our kids always know what to expect out of the Sea Life, you know, energy, the student crowds going back and forth, and, you know, the place is really loud and always has been, and, you know, a couple of our guys have been a part of a few of these already, so they knew what to expect, and Colts came in the first half, and we kind of pulled away in the second half and played really well.
You know, last year you guys go down state, and everybody said, well, they're done. Not so. You guys have done pretty good. You lost a bunch of kids, but you've got a pretty good team this year. Can you tell us about some of those kids that are helping you out this year, Coach?
Well, sure. You know, I mean, we did empty out in the sense of some really, really good players, you know, graduated, and that happens to everybody, you know, at some point. But it's really kind of how you conduct your business. And the, you know, these kids, a number of these kids in our program have been with us now for a couple of years, at least in a practice capacity, and have played some, you know, roles off the bench and so forth. And, you know, now it's their time. And you know, they've put in the time in the offseason. They have lifted the weights. You know, they have put in the time with the shooting and you know, putting in their 4 days a week in the summertime. You know, so these guys have earned the right to, you know, be a good basketball team. And I think we're building that. And, you know, we got the Larson twins, Zach and Alex, you know, been with us for a number of years and now are moving into more of a primetime role. Alex played his first really good game of the year last year. Zach's been pretty solid. Of course, A.J. Urich's been kind of a fixture for us. You know, he came off the bench for us last year, really played starters minutes. And, you know, he's a fixture for us in the middle. He's rebounding it, you know, double digits a game and scoring at double digits a game. And I don't think he's reached his fullest potential yet either. I mean, he's just starting to get comfortable this season. So, you know, we've got, you know, Andrew Epperson as a senior, has had some back injuries and stuff. He's starting to work his way back in. You know, we've had some couple of newcomers, and Alec maybe and Jake Dock would have made, you know, nice contributions. And then, you know, kind of a big surprise for us is the sophomore, Trey Williams, at the forward position. He's just really coming on. He's not a guy that spends a lot of time playing basketball, but he's a very natural athlete, and he can get in there and rebound and score in the paint for us. So, you know, we're starting to build out a nice little 7 or 8 man rotation where, you know, we feel like we can build some chemistry and be pretty good by the end of the year.
Are the kids this year taking a sense of pride? You know, having a good year this year, you know, coming off of the state title and losing kids can really stamp the program as having some staying power. So are the kids taking pride in that?
You know, they are. They know that, you know, in a lot of people's eyes outside the program, that less is expected of them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's not the way they feel. You know, last year we never put any goals on records or, you know, anything like that. We just better day in and day out, and that happened throughout the season. And so that they had at the end of the year, some of the accomplishments you had. And these guys are kind of taking the same approach. They know that, you know, they're not coming with quite the recognition from, you know, others when it comes to expectations. But it's not something that we really focus on. We just try to get better day in, day out. We know we've got talent. We're probably faster in the backcourt than we were last year. We're not nearly as tall. We're probably as good or better scorers in the post this year with our 3-4 rotation with Williams and maybe and A.J. Urig, but we're not as physical and we're not, you know, quite as dominant sometimes from a physical standpoint. So this is a different team. You know, whether it ends up being as good remains to be seen. We're off to a pretty good start. We're 6-1. You know, we did lose to Byron. Byron's probably a top three team in 2A right now. If the polls came out, they are undefeated. It would have to be considered in the top five for sure. So I mean, I think they know they're building their season, and what we can be is a work in progress. You know, it was a work in progress last year. I mean, heck, we were 32-1 on the season, and I never felt like, oh boy, we've made it. You know, we're as good as we can be. I mean, that was a work in progress throughout the entire season, and it will be for this team too.
You know, this is your last year in the Northeastern Athletic Conference. Next year, you get to see Byron a lot and all those other big Northern West teams. That'll be another challenge for you guys over at Rockford Christian.
It will be, and it's, you know, it's sort of a welcome challenge. That's a great conference and with a lot of tradition in a lot of sports. And, you know, I think our guys are really looking forward to that. It's definitely a step up. You know, we're going to be over on the other side with Marengo and Burlington Central and Harvard and North Boone. And then we'll play a couple crossover games, which could include, you know, your Winnebagos and Byrons and those types of things. So, you know, I haven't taken a look at the schedule. I know they're out. I haven't taken a look at the schedule of who we're crossing over against, but we'll be on that. We'll be on the side with North Boone and the rest of those schools. So I think it's a nice change. It doesn't take us down to Chicago for games.
Right.
You know, the conference we're in right now is pretty spread out. You know, nobody knows a lot about the conference. It's only a single round robin situation with our conference. It's not your typical conference situation that we're in. And I kind of liked it, to be honest, because it's given me some flexibility in non-conference games to kind of put some teams on the schedule based on, you know, what we have on a given year. So we only play 8 conference games as it is. Now we'll go into more of a conventional setting and play a full conference schedule and, you know, not be worried about, you know, filling out the non-conference schedule. And then we look forward to playing some of those programs. So, I mean, I think it'll be a good transition for us.
Real quick, before we let you go, you were up in Wisconsin, very successful, did well at Beloit Memorial. What's the difference between Wisconsin and Illinois basketball? Is it all the same, or is there some different things you're seeing since you've been down in the Rockford area?
No, that's a great question. You know, I've been asked that before, and I just think it's the way I would characterize it would be that I think the small school basketball in Illinois is better. I see quality sometimes in Illinois in smaller schools that can compete with bigger schools. You know, I saw that last year with our team. I saw some teams at the 2A level last year that I know darn right could compete, you know, with the better, bigger schools in the Rockford area. And they don't always play each other, but I know that they can compete. And I've been impressed with that. I think Illinois definitely got the advantage of the small school basketball. I was at a big school in Wisconsin, at least my last job before coming to Rockford Christian, and I felt like maybe at times the big school basketball in that Big 8 conference that Boy Memorial was in was maybe a little bit better than the Nick 10. We played some Nick 10 schools, and, you know, year in, year out, I just felt like the quality at the big school level was a little bit more, maybe the quality at the small school level, you know, that way. So that would be the difference. The state tournaments are both wonderful. I've been to both of them. You know, Illinois does a great job of putting on their deal. I mean, they do a banquet for the kids, which is really nice. The whole thing at the Peoria Civic Center is phenomenally run. Wisconsin has it up on them a little bit in terms of they put the students down on the floor for the game, which I think is really good. You know, they put the students behind the basket for a cheering section, so the kids feel really close to the game. At Peoria, that's all season ticket holders, so the kids, you know, the community fans are upstairs, which I think takes a little bit of environment away from it, but you know, they're both really well run, and you know, any kid who's fortunate enough to be able to, you know, have that experience the way that our kids did last year, you know, it's great, whether you're from Wisconsin or Illinois, I guess.
Hey, thanks for being with us today, Coach. I know you got a busy night. I think you're going down to Aurora to play Illinois Math and Science Academy. That must be a smart bunch down there, don't you think, with a name like that?
Yeah, you know, it's definitely, you know, we consider ourselves pretty academically strong, I think, at RC, and definitely with the Math and Science Academy, and you know, kids are, the JV kids are sitting in the bleachers during the varsity game with their laptops open. So they're pretty committed. They're pretty committed down there. I think it's a pretty fine academic institution, and you know, they'll come out and compete and give us the best they have, and we'll do the same and see what it shakes out. And then after this game, you know, we got another rival next week in Lutheran, and we know how good a team they have and how much they've improved. So nothing but fun rivalry games and stuff here before Christmas, and we go down to a really good Plano tournament. So we're excited about the next couple weeks.
Thanks a lot, Coach, and good luck tonight, too. And Merry Christmas.
Thanks, you too.
Thank you.
We've been talking to Rockford Christian basketball coach Shane Bouch. I'll tell you what, he's got a good program. He's got his pedigree and his resume is awesome.
It's not a surprise they're doing well.
That's good. It's kind of fine. And I was going to say to him before we let him go, I said, Rockford Christian, Rockford Lutheran, no love lost in that.
Not at all.
They may be Christian schools, but when they get on the floor, buddy, look out. I remember that game a few years ago. We're going to take a real quick time. I'll be back with our wrap-up here on the State Line Sports Hour right here on News Talk 1440 WROK.